If you're strengthened by the Lord, maybe we can stand up and sing that kind of one part.
The joy of the Lord is my strength. The joy of the Lord. Thank you. Probably you have somebody's burden.
somebody shared with you something and you want to stand in the gap on their behalf, I want us to stand in the place of intercession this very moment. If you have anybody in a place of sickness, you know, anybody that is going through one challenge or another, you listen to what was shared on the very first day when we came, and you feel a burden for somebody else, I don't want you to pray for yourself. I want you to stand in the gap because of somebody. Whether they be here, whether they be away, I want us right this moment to stand in the place of intercession, ask for Lord's intervention, ask for the Lord's mercy, for the Lord's breakthrough. I just want us to pray for the Lord's healing, for the Lord's voice, for the Lord's direction. I want us to all stand in the gap on behalf of somebody in the name of Jesus. Just open your heart and intercede for somebody right now in the name of Jesus. You have somebody definitely that you know things are not going well. Cry for souls unto salvation in the name of Jesus Christ. Ooh, come on, lift somebody up before the Lord right now. Lift somebody up before the Lord right now in the name of Jesus. Financial breakthrough. Are they in a relationship challenge? Pray for them. In the name of Jesus, are they sick? Suffering cancer, suffering all manner of sickness. Pray for them right now in the name of Jesus. Thank you.
Thank you. Yes, Lord.
Things were made by the Word. Read your Bible well. Praise Jesus. Hallelujah. It is important for us to hear what the Word of God is saying. and not interpret it of our own understanding. This scripture is talking about one who is called the Word. Hallelujah. And the Bible says, in the beginning was the Word. And the Word was with God. And the Word was God. And the same was with God in the beginning. There is a distinction, a clear distinction between the Word and God, yet they are one. Hallelujah. And he goes on to say that there was all things were made by the Word. And there was nothing that was made without the Word. Everything that we see under the sun today was made by the Word. Hallelujah. Amen. This Word is Jesus himself. If you go to the book of Revelation, you will be able to see it in chapter 5. And I think also in chapter 5 and probably chapter 7, where the Bible records clearly talking about Jesus as the Word. Whatever to be. And the angels following after the Word. Praise be to Jesus. The angels follow after the Word because they only know how to hear the Word. Praise be to Jesus. When Ezekiel was met and he was asked what he sees, he says, I see the branch like that of an almond tree. And he said, you have seen right. I will hasten my word to perform it. Jesus is the Word. And the same was there in the beginning. I don't know, but whenever you look at nature, if you go by the beach and you look over the ocean, there is something that comes into your mind. What comes into your mind? God. Hallelujah. When I look at the sea, I see God. And I see the vastness of God. I see the might of God. He is the only one who has the ability to make sure that the water has gone back there. Even if you don't put a barrier, they will never pass. For those who have traveled in the air, and you are up in the plane, and you behold what is up there, what do you think about? You actually think about God. You know you are in the air in some created thing by human beings, but when you look out your window, you actually see God. Praise be to Jesus. Hallelujah. Yesterday we were reading from the book of Job that all these waters are where? In the hollow of his hand. Did you read that? All the waters of the world are in the hollow of his hand. And the earth is more water than that. Praise be to Jesus.